cinnamon bell.
When we left Judy and Jimmy and the cinnamon bear last time, they were in high spirits, and for a very good reason, too. You'll remember that after the crazy quilt dragon sat on the silver star and broke it into a dozen pieces, they decided to visit Melissa, the beautiful queen of Babyland, to see if she could help them. And sure enough, after the grand wonky presented them to Queen Melissa, she told them the silver star could be restored to one piece if they'd listen carefully to everything she said. And I, for one, am going to listen very carefully because this is most interesting.
You mean you can fix it so our silver star will be all together again and won't be broken like it is now?
That's exactly what I mean, Judy.
Jiminy crickets. And will we be able to put it on our Christmas tree just like we used to?
On the very tip top, Jimmy, and no one will ever know it was the very least bit broken.
Oh, that'll be wonderful.
Now, I will have to write a few simple instructions for you to follow. Grand Wonky, will you please get me my magic ink?
Yes, Your Majesty.
We're awfully grateful, Melissa. We were just about to give up and go home.
You bet. And after all the things we did to get the star, too.
Here's the magic ink, Your Majesty.
Thank you, Grand Wonky. And now I will write down the instructions for you to follow. There. Now, I've put the instructions inside this envelope, Jimmy, and you must follow them exactly.
Oh, goody. Let's see what we have to do.
Oh, I'm sorry, Judy, but you mustn't open it here.
Oh, why?
Because that would keep the magic from working. You see, restoring the silver star is going to take a special kind of magic. If it had been made in Maybeland, it would be simple, but unfortunately, it was made in the world, and that's another matter. It will need quite a little extra work.
Will it be hard to do?
No, not hard, but you must do exactly as they say. And unfortunately, you can only read these instructions in total darkness.
But, Your Majesty, where can we find this absolute darkness?
Ah, that is a part of the magic that you must do for yourselves. But don't worry, friends. I know it will work out all right.
Gee, Melissa, I don't know how we'll ever be able to thank you.
It'll just make Christmas perfect, Melissa.
Allow me to express my deepest thanks, Melissa, for past favors and present courtesy. I bow.
I'm not fancy, Melissa, but I'm much obliged to you.
And you are all quite welcome, dear friends. I hope you will visit me again after the silver star has been restored to its original beauty.
We'd sure like to, all right, Melissa.
Then do so. And now, Grand Wonky, would you please set our friends on their way? I would be happy to entertain you in my palace for a while, but I know you're anxious to see your star mended and safe.
Yes, ma'am. Thanks so much, but we do have to hurry, kinda.
Yes, we've got to get it back before Christmas.
Well, goodbye then, and good luck.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Your Majesty.
Will you please follow me, single file, if you please, in the order in which you came in?
By the way, Wonky old thing, could you drop us some slight hint as to where we might find this absolute darkness of which Melissa spoke?
I couldn't hint. It's ever so rude. But my duties as Grand Wonky to Melissa's court keep me quite confined. I don't know a great deal about the country of Maybeland at all, I'm sorry to say.
Oh, dear.
But I have heard. Now, mark you, this is only a rumor. I cannot verify it in any way. I have heard that the Wishing Woods are very dark. Extremely dark, in fact.
Do you happen to know the way to the Wishing Woods?
Oh, yes, I do. I'm happy to say. I got a good many travel folders on it before I went on my vacation. But Mrs. Wonky decided she'd rather go to the root beer seashore. And such a lovely time we had, too. Took a small cottage.
Yes.
Dear. Now, where was I?
You were going to tell us how to get to the Wishing Woods.
Oh, yes, so I was. Well, it won't take you very long, not at all. They're directly north of the Marshmallow Meadows as the crow doesn't fly.
Thanks, Wonky. Much obliged for the assistance.
No, don't ever mention it. Just pop along down the marble staircase and straight ahead and... Dear, almost forgot something. Here, this box is for you to take along with you.
What's in it, Wonky? Some more magic?
Oh, you'll find out when the time comes. And, here's the door. My, 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 I must see about oiling those hinges, mustn't I? Such a racket to make. Well, I've got to be zipping now. Charming of you to drop in. Dudley, fetch the oil can.
What a character. What a character. You'd never know he was around.
I thought he was sort of sweet, Crazy Quilt.
Just a windbag, that's all. Well, we better get started, hadn't we?
You bet. Come on, everybody. Let's find the Wishing Woods. I wonder if this is the Wishing Woods.
Oh, I'm sure it is. There's a sign over there that says Wishing Woods.
Oh, I'm so glad. Look, there's another sign. What does it say?
Wait a minute. It's printed a bit smaller. Oh, S.S. Crocodile-esque.
What does that esque mean?
I expect it means to esque S.S. Crocodile.
Oh, I guess he spells like me.
Have you still got the broken pieces of the Silver Star in your hanky, Jimmy?
Yep, safe and sound.
Well, you have Melissa's instructions, too. So I think I better carry your hanky for you.
All right, here it is.
And now, shall we follow this little path? Seems to be as good as any. Maybe this crocodile person can give us some idea as to where it is totally dark in the Wishing Woods.
He might at that.
Cinnamon Bear, did you look in that box that the Grand Wonky gave you when we left the palace?
No, why?
I was just awful curious, that's all.
Well, there's no special orders about opening this, so here it goes.
Oh.
But this my stuffing cinnamon buns.
Let me see. Oh, Jimmy, peanut butter sandwiches and apple pie.
And lollipops, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, boy. Oh, this is swell.
Oh, here's a note. My dear friends, I hope you will enjoy your picnic lunch in the Wishing Woods. When you have finished, tie up the box again, and the next time you are hungry, open it, and you will find another lunch. Love, Melissa.
Gee, Melissa sure's a peach, all right.
Well, far be it from me to call our gracious ruler by such a name, but she surely is kind and thoughtful.
Yummy. Such genuine ones. Just full of currants, too.
My, I didn't know I was hungry, but I certainly was.
Delicious. I'll tie up the box just like she said.
Well, shall we be moving? Oh, I say, look ahead, down the path a bit.
My goodness, it's a bathtub.
Yeah, and it's a big white one, just like we have at home.
What a strange place for a bathtub.
What's that funny noise?
It's coming from the bathtub.
Why, so it is. There must be something in it.
Oh, bless my stuffing, it's a crocodile.
It must be the one on the sign. S.S. Crocodile-esque.
Welcome to the Wishing Woods. Who am I? I can see it by the look in your eye. Why, I'm Snappersnake. Of course. By the way, who are you?
I'm Judy, Mr. What did you say your name was?
Snappersnake, little girl. And who are the rest of you?
I'm Jimmy.
Patio Cinnamon, the Cinnamon Bear.
I'm the Crazy Quilt Dragon.
Well. So kind of you to come all this way to see me.
But we...
I'm very glad you came today. There hasn't been a single person, and I was beginning to feel quite lonesome.
Well, you see...
Of course, I'm very comfortable, with my bath, like my tub. Quite an acquisition it was, very. I got it when they redecorated the royal bath last spring. Genuine porcelain with chromium taps.
It's very nice, but you see...
But you say one can't spend all one's time in the bath. Ha-ha! That's because you've never thought of the bath in all its possibilities.
You are quite right,
but... Have you ever noticed the wonderful acoustics in a bathtub? Of course you haven't. Have you ever thought of a bathtub singing as a fine art? Again, you have not. But Snappersnake has. Oh, yes, indeed. That is why I have remained a hermit, as it were, in the midst of the Wishing Woods, perfecting my art until it can be heard in all its glory by the listening world. The first bathtub singer to be heard on the air. What a sensation! The bathtub baritone. Snappersnake, the crooning crocodile.
But we didn't...
But you didn't come to talk. You came to hear me sing. Isn't that right? Well, your wish is granted. I'll sing without delay.
We didn't come to see you.
Oh, you didn't? Why didn't you say so?
Sure, and you didn't give us a chance.
These young people are on a very important mission.
Oh, indeed. And where did you come from?
Just now, we came from the Queen of Maybeland.
Oh, dear, dear Melissa. And how is she always so kind to me? Melissa is so kind. Lovely girl, don't you think?
She's awful nice, all right. She's going to help us fix our silver star.
What silver star?
Ours. It belongs on top of our Christmas tree. First it got lost.
Lost? Oh, and don't I know how you must feel. Don't I, though? Last spring, I lost my voice.
Congratulations.
What do you mean, congratulations? For days, I was petrified. And then my beautiful voice came back. Twice as lovely as ever before. However, it's too bad you weren't here to notice the improvement. I'll demonstrate by singing my favorite number. That's why crocodiles were born, in the key of Q.
But we haven't time to listen. Besides, the star isn't lost anymore. We found it, and it got broken into a dozen pieces.
And Melissa gave us some wonderful instructions so we can get it all back together again.
But they aren't to be read except in total darkness.
Oh, most intriguing. May I take a squint?
Of course. They're right here in this envelope.
My, my, would you mind holding it a little closer? Broke my bifocals last week. Can't see worth anything.
There. You sure ought to be able to see now, Mr. Crocodile.
Ah, much better. Much better.
Hey, hey, don't do that.
Well, I never.
Our magic instructions. He swallowed them.
Well, there seems to be a regular epidemic of swallowing things, doesn't there? First, the wailing whale swallowed the silver star, then Crazy Quilt swallowed the whistle which Fifo the Giant gave to Jimmy, and now Snappersnick, the crooning crocodile, has upped and swallowed Melissa's most valuable instructions. Looks mighty bad, all right, but let's be on hand next time and see what happens.